Serious, failed suiciders, what was the aftermath and how did you adjust to going forward in life?
I remember the nurse was surprised that I woke up at all. The hospital informed me that although I was of age, I was being held regardless of my wishes because I was a danger. I was told that if I elected to try and leave, they would take me to court. I was placed in a psychiatric intensive care unit after my health had stabilized, PICU. That place was hell, but I have some good stories from it. My mother stopping by was a tough day. She said almost nothing. Eventually I got out. I was kicked out of the place I was living because I'd obviously not been working and couldn't afford rent, so didn't have a home. Bill collectors were rearing up. I even got parking tickets because I hadn't planned to survive. The pills they put me on killed all emotions, so I ended up doing soul-crushing work for a while. My friend took me in as a homeless bastard with little to no possessions. I slept in a chair we found by a dumpster. The choices were death or trying to make the best of it. I chose the latter because the meds stopped me from feeling sad. From there I started to rebuild my life. I wouldn't say it was the worst time of my life, but definitely a difficult one. When people tell me I must have had things easy because I'm happy all the time, I just smile and say yeah, something like that. I tried to slit my wrists, failed, and was temporarily hospitalized. I stopped taking the meds and lived a roller coaster ride of a life until I finally decided to stick with medication. This year, I'm still struggling daily. It's one of my greatest regrets. Not that I tried, but only because I failed. Failing something that literally every single person in existence can't escape. Fucking up something so easy as that. I really regret that. I shut myself in, didn't speak for 2+ years straight. Literally out loud, I may have said a few words all up. I tried to do it again, explosives, poisons, etc. But was always frightened that I would fuck up again. Especially get in a state that I couldn't kill myself and just be stuck. Drifting through time, unable to move as my mind tears itself apart. I don't know what got me out of it, literally. I do not know how I went from that to being a human again. It instantly changed, and I am afraid if I ever get in that position again, I will not know a single thing which will help. Since then I have spent the vast majority of my time working for a lot of money. Spent a majority of time trying to stop other people from killing themselves. I know, confirmed by follow-ups, I've stopped 1,000 people so far. All my money I spend on the essentials and give the rest to everyone else. My life isn't my own, I see it as only living for the sake of others. Didn't happen on me. Apparently decided to die in the showers at midnight. Found by the first guy that entered. Nobody knew why. The day before we had a nice talk, and the one night later spent days in the emergency. Never had a sign of depression, nor any sign of it happening. Was so sudden, absolutely nobody believed it. Personality changed 180 degrees. Didn't talk, didn't interact with people much, acted as if was air. Would appear and leave without being noticed. No attempts of talking were successful. Had no emotions at all, as if appreciated the world without. Few cared. People forgot fast. And had no emotion to anything, just exists. Was equal to actually dead. Probably exactly what was looked for. Disappeared few months after. Little remember his existence, and none knew what happened after. Dash. I tried suicide at 14 years old. I was fed up with my life, dealt with emotional, mental, and some forms of sexual abuse by my mother. I felt like I was worthless, nobody loved me, I didn't deserve to be on this earth. Grabbed a belt in my room and put it around my neck, latching it on as hard as I could. Started to get lightheaded, faint, and knew it was coming. But at that moment, I thought of my little brother who was 2 years younger than me. Who would have been the one to walk into my room and find me? I couldn't do that to him. He was my best friend and he needed me. I undid the belt and ran to my mother, woke her up, and told her what I did. She ran and got my dad. They took me to Children's Hospital the next day. I was placed into a psych ward for kids under the age of 18, for 5 days. Got placed on a higher dose of antidepressants, started on antidepressants at age 11, got into counseling, and went into my freshman year as the crazy girl who tried suicide. Luckily, I was from a super small farm town, everyone knew everyone, literally less than 40 kids in my grade, and everyone came to accept it. I'm still on antidepressants to this day, fell into a very abusive marriage, which I left before he could fulfill his promise of killing me. I'm in therapy, and working on improving my mental health. It's taken me a long time to get where I am, but it's made me into the person I am today. I wouldn't change a thing about my past. It all eventually led to 3, almost 4, due in January, kids, a kinder more compassionate heart, and even more desire to become a nurse so I can one day help others who have been in shitty situations as I have been in. My advice is to reach out to anyone you possibly can. Don't be ashamed of how you're truly feeling and doing. We're all humans and we all crack. We all need a helping hand at times, Black Heart. My dad called poison control. I went to the emergency room where I was kept on suicide watch, and after a while of being questioned, I was made to go to a psychiatric hospital. I got out in 8 days. I went to school after I got out 11th grade. Word got around about what I did do. I had to deal with that for a while. I had to deal with the emotions of feeling like I failed. Honestly, I woke up the next morning and thought I didn't take enough pills and was deeply ashamed. I cried and cried. Then I took a shower and got ready for work. Went to work hating myself for not making it happen. Never told anyone, just kept it to myself in the back of my head. Realized that maybe I just wasn't meant to take my life. I'm not sure how I feel about it now. I feel myself spiraling again. But at least this time around I am seeking help in a more persistent manner. Took a bunch of my mom's blood pressure meds. Not enough apparently. I was also holding a knife to my throat when I blacked out apparently, and there was a cut on my throat. My mom came to the ER with me and told me not to tell me dad because it would kill him. Partially because of him I did it, so when I got home I made like I just got back from staying at my friend's house. Went to a treatment center for teens 5 months shortly after. Denied it happened to them so they wouldn't force me to stay longer. I think about doing it again but don't have the guts anymore. First time I tried to commit suicide, I took all of my depression meds and ran away from home. The police found me a few blocks away and the ambulance took me to the hospital. The worst thing I remember was the taste of the charcoal I had to drink and the long tube that went up my nose. I was placed in a psych ward, and after a few days in there my family came to see me, and all they could talk about was how my actions made the family look bad and how I needed to control my little outburst better. Since then I've tried to do it a couple more times in my teenage years. 2012 was the last year I tried to take my life, and I'm really glad I failed. I still struggle with my depression sometimes, but I realized that I had something to live for. That reason being my 2 younger sisters. To be able to move forward and make sure that they never saw through anything I had to go through alone, with no one to say I'm here for you no matter what. I love my life for them because I love them dearly. Took an ambulance to the hospital. They shoved IVs into my arms and made me drink activated charcoal. My mom yelled at me when she saw me getting into the ambulance. I stayed at the hospital for a few hours, then took the bus home. The hospital had to give me a bus ticket cause I didn't have any money. I just slept for a couple days after, was in pain, and then that Friday I had a job interview, which in part triggered the attempt. Nothing really happened, honestly. I just went back to normal as if nothing had happened. Decided I wouldn't try that again unless I was serious and sure I would end it cause I didn't need another $400 ambulance bill. The family member of someone I'm close to weighs 350 pounds. He was once found taking a pair of scissors to his rolls of fat. He has anxiety and family issues. He was stressed with university and downed a bottle of his anxiety medication mixed with whatever he found in his parents' medicine cabinet. His younger sister found him. His weight saved him, I think. The entire family was happy and cheery in the hospital and completely ignored what happened. Playing cards, making fun of each other. Nothing was changed afterward to prevent it from happening again. They just ignored it.